Get ready to match the stars from Shannara Bowser, Greg Summers, Charles Nelson Riley from Dallas, Charlene Slogan, Bill Daly, and Patty Dukaskin as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Guys. Thank you for joining us here on Match Game PM. You're going to have a good time.
Yeah.
I dare say the sequins were unnecessary.
Yes. And which sequins
was it? I did it for you.
Oh, thank you very much. All
right.
Would you all join me in greeting Tom Nail and Terry Keller?
Hello.
Welcome to both of you. If you want to get acquainted, find out who you are and where you're from, Terry, tell us about yourself, please.
Okay. I'm a second-generation San Diegan. And I work in La Jolla as a cocktail waitress, and I'm also working part-time as a travel agent.
Well, you're a busy lady.
Have a couple of belts, and she'll send you anywhere.
No orders, please.
Pardon?
Very nice.
Tom, what about you? Where are you from?
I'm from down south, a computer programmer for airlines in Atlanta.
Okay.
Hobbies are snow skiing and just having a good time out here visiting some relatives.
Right. There's not much snow around Atlanta, though, is there?
No, we have to go elsewhere for it. But
where do you go?
It's a great city, though. A lot of time in Utah. We've been to Utah a couple of times.
Yes.
Just a hop, skip,
Western
and a jump.
Skiing.
Yeah, about a mile away.
Yes. What is a Peter programmer?
Computer programmer.
I'm sorry. Tom. As we have pointed out many times on the program, older people like Brett have trouble with their vision, with their hearing, and all that. Now, here on Match Game PM, you'll each have three opportunities to match as many of those creatures as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round, that person will be the winner and will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. Here we go. Terry, you want A or B?
A, please.
Terry says she wants A. The Surgeon General has announced he's going to put a warning on all TV sets that says, "Caution, watching blank may make you sick."
Are you drinking again?
The Surgeon General has announced he's going to put a warning on all TV sets that says, "Caution, watching blank may make you sick."
General Hospital.
Oh. General Hospital. On kind of the blood and the gore and the surgery and all the bedpans and all. I see. Okay.
Your sister didn't.
She
like
says
it.
General Hospital.
And how beautifully this opening segment led into the definitive answer of what's going to make you sick on television, a match game. Yeah.
No.
No.
Okay.
I was influenced by.
Excuse me.
He don't get
don't
out
talk
much.
With a mouthful.
I was influenced by Shannon. I also, he said, that this is a winning answer. He said, he matched it.
I believe it.
We can do without both of you.
I was going to say Reuben Brothers three-piece suit. So I said match game AM and PM.
You can all be eliminated, you know.
I guess we'll all be going.
Yes, you will.
Before I go, I'll give my answer.
You can be eliminated, too.
All I don't care.
Just leave the dress.
Yes, and the... No.
No. What did you say?
I put the Bob Newhart Show, I Dream of Jeannie, and Match Game. Any one of those are rotten.
Well, that's fine, people. We're not going to have back on this program.
Good, yay!
What do
then
you
we
say?
Won't have a program.
Now, I don't want anyone on this show to be upset. Not this show. The one that I said on my little card here. Because I think it's a very good show. But it goes on and on and on and on. The Price is Right.
The Price is Right.
My favorite show.
Your favorite show?
Yeah. Do I get to stay here?
You're
I
okay.
certainly can't go to
You're
the prices right now.
We can build a whole new panel of celebrities with Patty Duke Aston as the basis for the whole thing.
All That's right. I can play all the parts.
Right.
Tonto. That I am.
Tonto.
Tonto.
Who?
Tonto.
Yes, dear. I didn't say who. She said who.
Well, I knew you had a hearing problem.
So does Thelma Ritter down there in the 6th Z.
Tonto left the Lone Ranger.
Oh, that's...
Oh, yeah. No,
he'll never work again.
You didn't hear about it, did you? He opened an Indian restaurant. When the Lone Ranger came to the door, Tonto said,
"Oh, sorry, Kimo Sabe, but to get in here, you need blank."
They stink. That stink.
Patty?
What about that?
No.
You waiting for me?
Yes.
Oh. Your stink.
All right, here we go.
Mine's a defendant.
Tonto left the Lone Ranger and opened an Indian restaurant. When the Lone Ranger came to the door, Tonto said,
"Sorry, Kimo Sabe, but to get in here, you need
a squaw."
A squaw. That's all right. He matches the others who really didn't understand it either. Obviously. No one understands
Patty,
the question.
Did you like that answer?
You got it?
I didn't answer.
Okay, we'll call on you last.
Okay.
We'll call on Charles last. What do you say?
Okay, right on. Terrific.
Huh?
Show us your card.
Heavy, baby.
Oh, I have to definitely the definitive answer. War paint.
War paint. Yeah. Okay. Don't come back till we call you, dingbat.
He's had the flu. He hasn't been
He
well.
Has the green apple quick step. He's just pretending.
Oh, I see.
Well, that was scalp, and there was tribe. And there was feathers.
Yeah, those are no better.
And there was mask.
No
and there
better.
Was horse. But what I chose was squaw.
All right, that's one for time.
Oh, we're going to call on you last. And we'll come down here to you. What have
oh,
you got
I've
here?
Heard that one before. He'll never get back to you.
Yes.
I like it, Charlene.
What? He said a peace pipe. If not that, a bong or something, you know.
A peace pipe.
Bong.
It's like bing bong.
I was gonna say.
Get the door.
I don't know what this means. I was gonna say doorknobs or master charge, so I took master charge.
Master charge.
Doorknobs
would
be a very clever answer.
You think you have the definitive answer?
Okay, you ready for mine?
Go.
I said an American Pony Express card with a silver bullet, or I was gonna say Playboy Bunny card. And none of them are any good.
Does that
match? Interesting.
But there is no match there. Because
yeah, it's a question that's bad.
Now, Charles thinks he had the definitive answer.
I have the definitive answer.
All right. I'll
read the question. Charles.
I'll read the question one more time for you. Tonto left the Lone Ranger to open an Indian restaurant. When the Lone Ranger came to the door, Tonto said,
"Sorry, Kimo Sabe, but to get in here, you need
wampum."
That's what I was thinking of.
Hold it. Wait a minute, America. Does anybody in the audience know what the difference... That's it. Reservation.
I get it. I'm out of this now. This thing's not matches.
Yes,
oh,
wonderful.
Boy, that's good.
All right, we'll get the round
did
two
you
in a moment
think
or so.
Of that? Yeah. Think
no,
of that?
I didn't think of that. Look at that. Watch it.
Everybody.
Okay, now we'll go to round two. Tom, your head, you may go first.
I'll take A.
A. Everyone except Brett.
Reservation.
Hey, listen.
That's because she matched.
Right.
That was
Other
good.
People would say, that got
That was good, audience. That was yes. very good.
Squaw,
now listen
squaw.
To this.
Very good.
Are you ready?
Boy, that was so good, everybody. I'll tell you.
Are you ready?
Boy, you are really a wonderful.
What?
Yeah. Boy, that's a good audience.
He's got a better angle. He's got a much better angle.
He has his dress chains on for the late show, I know.
It's only rubble.
Now listen. Rubble wear. You know the terrible rash you get from touching poison ivy?
No.
Yes, you know about the terrible you get.
Wait, this is the question.
This is the question. I'm talking to you. You got to write something.
Okay, I wrote it. Well, the answer is doorknob.
Wait a minute.
Reservation.
Now, wait a minute.
Reservation.
I have a question.
I
got
to have
Well,
what I love is how you keep complete control of the situation.
Harvey, this guy Harvey has an even worse rash. He got it from blanking poison ivy.
Well,
what That's the whole question. Why didn't you listen? I didn't mean what I was doing.
Hey, 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 don't hit her.
Is it okay?
It's okay. It's okay. Don't hit me again. I don't like it. What are the girls around? We don't have anybody with cleavage.
What's your question? One more time, the question. Shut up! You're ready, or your faces.
I'm being very quiet.
You know the terrible rash you get from touching poison ivy? This guy Harvey has an even worse rash. He got it from blanking poison ivy.
Did he do that? I told him not to. These are the nighttime questions, huh?
Right.
Look, I'll be back in the morning.
Tom, you're familiar with the terrible rash you get from touching poison ivy.
Yes.
Right? Now, this guy Harvey has an even worse rash. He got it from blanking poison ivy.
Wearing poison ivy.
Wearing poison ivy.
Oh, what a night. I like it.
Don't put that down. You're going to take it back over there.
Okay.
Let's take good care of it.
What do you got?
I thought, figured he went to the Indian restaurant and he got it from eating poison ivy.
Eating poison ivy.
Poison ivy, though.
Right.
Should be poison ivy. That's what confused you.
A little late with reservation, but a nice try.
Well, your reservation's at
eating.
The ivy.
Eating. Okay. Tom said wearing poison ivy.
I said eating or kissing.
Eating or kissing poison ivy. All right.
I said he went to bed with poison ivy. Remember her?
She went to my high school.
She did?
There's a song like that. That's true.
She went to my.
They had a
poison
stupid
ivy.
Answer.
Making love to poison ivy.
I meant in making love in poison ivy.
Terry, are you ready for yours?
Yep.
Here it is. Listen, there's an inspirational new book. It's out. It's written by a cannibal.
Oh, this is another question.
Yes.
Oh, we haven't done our 15 minutes of shtick yet, though.
No.
So quick with another question, you're confusing us.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Yay!
There's our 50 minutes of shtick.
It's an inspirational new book out written by a cannibal. It's called How to Blank Your Fellow Man.
No?
Terry, there's this inspirational new book out written by a cannibal. It's called How to Blank Your Fellow Man.
Eat.
How to eat your fellow man. Okay.
Well, I figured since we just had Eat, and since you had it was something that you were going to be a reader of because it was a book, that the answer was digest.
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 That's different from Eat, huh?
Right.
Oh, don't be cruel.
The eating is simple. It's the digesting that's hard, believe me.
Boil.
How to boil your fellow man.
The correct answer.
All right, Charles. Thank you, Terry. Darlene.
It was an inspirational book. I read it. How to Cook and Eat Your Fellow Man.
How to Cook and Eat. All right. That's two.
Wait, I know we're going to have a little we're going to have a little problem with this one, but I think I'm right. How to Lick Your Fellow Man. Is licking even... What do you do with an ice cream cone? What do you swallow it?
Right.
You know, eating is not licking is not eating?
No, it's different.
What do you do with an ice cream cone?
That's different.
I'll tell you at home, then.
All right, Patty.
Sing, Dennis.
Burl.
Burl.
Okay, 2-1 the score at the end of round two. We go to round three, and Terry, since you're ahead, you have your choice of A or B.
A, please.
It is. Four people play. Bowser, Brent, Bill, and Patty.
Bowser,
Weird Willie
Bowser,
has the
Brent,
world's
Bill.
Strangest job.
How strange is it?
Is it?
Strange.
Go, baby.
He's an undercover dog catcher. All day long, he stands around disguised as a blank. Weird Willie has the world's strangest job. He's an undercover dog catcher. All day long, he stands around disguised as a...
Fire hydrant.
Fire hydrant. Yeah! Okay, show us your fire hydrant.
This is my fire hydrant.
There it is. What do you got?
Moving along together.
fire hydrant.
Another one for her. And you, sir?
How about fire hydrant?
How about fire hydrant? How about those? Five for her. And that's another one. And she had it, too. Now, Tom, the best you could do is achieve a tie, but you can do that by matching five stars. Here we go. At the funeral, it took over an hour to close Old Man Periwinkle's coffin because Old Man Periwinkle was blank. Anytime, Bowser. Remember, you're the college graduate.
Oh.
You're just playing the part of the dummy.
Come over here and say that. Oh, after the question. Oh, Gene, it's only rubber.
Write an answer.
It's only rubber. A man at another network made that 5 years ago for $110.
At the funeral, it took over an hour to close Old Man Periwinkle's coffin because Old Man Periwinkle was...
still alive.
Still alive. All right.
Oh, you said it already?
Still alive.
Just in the nick of time.
Yeah, I said sitting up.
Sitting up.
He'd have to be alive if he's sitting up.
I have trouble sitting up.
Is that a man or a man? That's not a man. Okay, that means Terry Keller wins again. What do you have here? Alive.
Still alive.
Alive. Alive, standing up.
Alive, alive, alive.
All right, come on down, Terry. Right there, please. Tom, many gifts coming your way.
It was a pleasure.
Be with us here on Magic.
Brilliant.
Tom Nail, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
I will send him off and send a message for you. Hurry back. See how much money she wins. Here we go.
Okay.
Terry Keller, ready?
Yeah.
There it is. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Folding blank. $500 for you if you match the most popular answer. $250 for the second most popular. $100 for the third. Three of the six stars will assist you, but call on the ones with a bright look on their faces.
How about Bowser?
Bowser.
Me?
Yeah.
I had a bright look on my face. I love you. Folding chair.
There's one.
Charles.
Charles was asleep.
I took Charlie's answer, I think, yeah.
What you and Brett have in the trunk of the car on the way to Encino, folding cot.
He really reached for that one, didn't he?
Okay, stick with the men. How about Bill?
Oh, bye, you devil.
Table's too much like Beth. Folding
money,
table,
money.
Folding
money.
Folding up.
Folding money. Folding up.
Folding money.
Folding money. Let's do that.
Folding money. So you have folding money, folding cot, folding chair. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Chair.
Folding chair.
Yeah, very good.
All right. Let's find out if it's up there. We'll begin by revealing the $100 response. Folding money is there.
Ha-ha.
Let's see if we got a folding chair under the next one, please. Folding paper. It looks pretty good
folding
for you, my dear. Here we go with a big one. Go.
Big in Japan.
Folding chair. Means the least you'll play for is $5,000.
Okay.
But we got one more audience match for you, and we'll see how much more money you can win. All right, here it is. Answer the blank. Answer the blank. All
right. Okay, Charlene, please.
The question.
All right, there's one.
Patty?
Answer the man.
Okay. Answer the man.
I don't know.
And Brett, please.
Just a minute, sweetheart. Answer the door.
Oh, that's very good.
Answer the door, answer the question, answer the man. Do you want one of those?
Question.
Yes, I'll take question.
Answer the question. That was Charlene.
Answer the
phone. Let's see if we got to answer the question under the $100 response. Answer the door is there. That was one they gave you. Let's see the next one, please. Answer the phone. I think you did it again, by Jove. Let's find out right now. Yes, you did. Another $500 means another $5,000 added to the previous. It's $10,000 you're playing for, but you're going to spin the star wheel. You can double it to $20,000. Good luck and go. It must make one complete revolution.
Go, go, go.
Bowser, get set. Here we go. Stand right there and face this way. Thank you. And good luck to you for $10,000. Here it is. Benjamin Blank. Benjamin Blank.
Was that new music?
All right. Now, he's written his answer on the card. If you give us the same answer, you get $10,000. What do you say?
Franklin.
You say Franklin. Bowser? He says Benjamin Franklin will match you for the $10,000. Here's a little message for you.
Okay, we got it. Yeah.
Listen, she could have said Benjamin Moore. She could have said Benjamin Harrison, but
Benjamin
she didn't.
Schwartz.
She said
Benjamin
Franklin.
Britton.
She's got $11,000, and we'll see you next week on Next in PM. Goodbye.
Some contestants. Spray available in regular and extra hold and well-placed conditioning setting lotion. The setting lotion that conditions as you set. An affordable radio and Popeyes Fun Delicious, a terrific freeze at home treat. 12 bars and assorted flavors treat your youngsters with refreshing Popeyes. And a t-shirt and Armor All Protectant slows aging and vinyl, rubber, wood, plastic, or leather. Protect things worth keeping with Armor All Protectants. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.